project inspiration comes from where else but the wonderful land of Swedish meatballs, Ikea. So while I was at Ikea, I saw a shelf that consisted of four boxes sitting above a bed, and I thought, well, that's really nice. Unfortunately, I couldn't find the tag to figure out where to buy these boxes, so I decided to make some myself. Now I decided to make mine roughly 4 feet long, with four foot tall boxes. First thing I do, measure that out, mark a line. So, since we don't have a table saw, we're going to be using the circular saw, and I'm going to make a fence so that the cut comes out straight. So I'm going to measure to the opposite side of the teeth. That gives me 1 3/8". Oh, no. I want to cut to the close side of the teeth. So that gives me just a hair over 1 1/4". So we are going to put a fence at 1 1/4" from the line. Mark up our fence. Check that everything is nice and square. Before adding the other clamp. And we're going to make our cuts. So both these 4 foot boards are going to have some dados cut into them. I'm going to do that with the router. Right now I'm going to just make a mark holding this guy flush just to see approximately how far that's going to be, and I'm going to do that on the other side. So from where our dado or rabbit or whatever you want to call it is going to start, we're going to make this 11 inches to there. All right, so now that we have those marked out, it's time to break out the router. So for a router, I've got this little Harbor Freight trim router. I'm running a 3/4 inch router bit that's going to be the same width as the stock. That way I only have to use one pass. All right, so I measured this already with a ruler to the edge, and I am 1 3/8" from the blade. So that means I need to make a mark 1 3/8" away from the my other mark. Now I got two little lines, so now time to add a fence.
So now I'm going to reset this for 1 3/8 from this guy. And then we're going to repeat. Add a little oopsie there. I think we'll still be okay. Well, even with a really bad data, we got a pretty tight fit. Let's hope the others go better. All right, now that we've cut the slots, now it's time to make the vertical pieces. I'm going to start by first making 3, and then making the other 2. That's mostly just because of the wood I have. Both our top and our bottom, as well as all 5 pieces. It's time to test fit. Alright, that looks pretty good. Now there's one more step. You may be wondering how we're going to hang this to the wall. I've got this little 1x3 right here, and we are going to make a notch for it in each one of these 3 middle pieces. And that's going to sit right there. We're going to put our screws in the middle, and that's how we'll hang it to the wall. So what I'm going to do is, without actually measuring, I'm going to set my combination square to the exact same width. Make sure that's nice and flush. Then I'm going to use this to transfer over to these guys, just to make a mark. So now I'm going to mark each one of these. Sides out. And we're going to take it apart. All right, now that I've got them cut, marked on the back side, and I've numbered them 1, 2, 3. Now we need to figure out how deep we need to cut this. So once again, I'm going to just reset my square to the thickness of the wood. And we're going to mark. I'm going to do this on both sides. So now I'm going to score along the line with my marking knife. Now we're going to take the saw. We're going to cut. So now I'm going to take my half-inch chisel and my mallet, and because this is soft pine, this should come out really easy. And we're just going to do that for the rest of the boards. Alright, so now after chiseling, we've got this pretty nasty edge, so I've set this up in the vise, and we're just going to peel that back, make it nice and smooth, that way we don't see a ratty edge from the outside. Now we've got the sides finished up, it's time to sand off all of the old pencil marks and glue it together. is dry and I've taken the clamps off. Now it's time to add the little back piece that we're going to use to hang it. So for that, I've got my pencil and our piece of wood. I'll lay that kind of in place and just mark the board. Should mention I make the mark right there with the marking knife to prevent tear out. Alright, let's see how we did. Excellent. Now time to pull it out and glue it in. This brace because it has this nice little ratcheting feature that lets me do this in these nut tight little areas. And there we go, a nice little countersunk hole. we've got our first coat on. Now we gotta wait 6 hours for that to dry before we do coat number two. Now we've got a second coat on. I'm going to take some steel wool to it to kind of polish it up a little bit, get rid of some of the roughness that you get with the stain, and then we'll